House Intelligence Committee Chairman Democrat Adam Schiff on Fox News Sunday this morning, ripping into Attorney General William Barr. Democrats accusing Mr. Barr of misleading Congress about some of the key conclusions in Robert Mueller's report. And they are vowing to push ahead with plans to investigate the president for obstruction of justice. Well, Mr. Barr is set to return to Capitol Hill for 2 days of testimony early next month. What will happen? Let's bring in Guy Lewis. He's a former U.S. attorney who served with the AG at the Justice Department under President George H.W. Bush. You know the criticism. Barr, he spun the conclusions. He's acting like the president's lawyer, not the people's. And as one Democrat, Rhode Island Democratic Congressman Dave Ciccoloni put it, quote, Barr lied through his teeth. Do you buy that?
Eric, I don't buy it one bit. This really is a perfect example of why prosecution and politics don't mix. I mean, the politics, there are no rules. They don't play by rules. Prosecutors, we played by rules, by the Constitution, by the policies of the Department of Justice. And frankly, that's exactly what Bill Barr's done here in terms of both reviewing the Mueller report and making the determinations that he's made.
Well, some say he misrepresented the fact that there was no conclusion on obstruction of justice. Not that it was clear, but because under the DOJ rules, as you know, you can't indict a sitting president. At least that's the view.
Well, that's certainly the department's policy as we speak. But when you take a step back and you look at this thing, truly, there was nothing that the attorney general could have done, frankly, that would have been without criticism. Had he not released his 4-page letter, guess what? People would have been griping. Had he released a 14-page letter, they would have said, oh, that's way too much, and again, you're misrepresenting. Had he not made a determination, he would have been subject to criticism. But he did exactly what he's supposed to do. Look, he's the attorney general. At the end of the day, the buck stops with the attorney general, and it is his determination whether to go forward or not to go forward.
Yeah, one point of contention has to do with his claiming that Mueller, you know, didn't really talk about going to Congress. But let me read you something from the Mueller report specifically about the obstruction of justice issues. Quote, we conclude the Congress has authority to prohibit a president's corrupt use of this authority in order to protect the integrity of the administration of justice. The conclusion that Congress may apply the obstruction laws to the president's corrupt exercise of the powers of office accords with our constitutional system of checks and balances and the principle that no person is above the law. So it seems that Mueller is thrown into the House. What do you think is going to happen there?
Well, in the House, they're going to look at this, and you can already see that people are coming out on all different sides of this issue. What's important, and I think what people need to understand, is that Barr is a man of integrity. He's a man of honor. He crosses his T's. He dots his I's. I first met him 30-plus years ago when he was the attorney general, when the 82nd Airborne Division brought out General Noriega, and we prosecuted him here in South Florida. In that case, I've got to tell you, what he cared about was making sure we followed the rules, making sure the Constitution was adhered to, making sure the defendant got a fair trial. I'm just telling you, the people should be very proud of this attorney general, as I am.
And finally, quickly, do you think that also means that he will go full bore into investigating the alleged FISA abuses and how this whole thing started in the first place with that now discredited Steele dossier, although it started with the Papadopoulos, but then exploded, you know, with the Carter Page FISA applications? Do you think he's going to do a complete investigation of that?
Boy, oh boy, good question. I do think he will, only because that's what he said he would do. He'll look at it. And I know that the Inspector General, Michael Horowitz, is also looking at it as well. So I think the department is going to get back on track. They're going to go about their business, and they're going to try to right some of these things that, frankly, sort of deviated left or right from the department's policy. I just know this, Eric, when General Barr is looking at a case, he doesn't care if you're a Democrat, Republican, independent, non-affiliated. He makes a decision based on the law and the facts.
All right. Guy Lewis, thank you, and happy Easter.